What is today? It's Wednesday, June 17th. Let me see. Let me look at my phone. June 17th. My goodness. We have 2 weeks left of June and the year is half over. What a great year 2020 has been so far, hasn't it been, gang? Well, I tell you what, if there is any kind of something, a nice takeaway, if you're looking, I think it's the, for me anyway, learning how to do the Zoom class and the Zoom concept and then putting that on YouTube and everything and making what we do here available, you know, at any time. Now, having said that, today is a Wednesday class, and on Wednesdays, we have black belt class, we have adult class, we have intermediate and advanced classes. So what I'm going to do is, we don't have any basic class, so let me start again. What I'm going to do is just, we're going to do a warm-up, we're going to do just skills throughout. And when I fall down and drop over from exhaustion, then we'll bow out. I think that'll be the end of it and stuff. So, yeah, you know, the old gray mare, you know, he's, you know, trying to do his best here and stuff. So without further delay, let's get rolling here. Not rolling like in jiu-jitsu. I need a partner for that, but just kind of like doing our karate stuff. All right, so tradition has it, we start with a bow and some jumping jacks. Let's go here. Well, since I'm the only one here, I can sit there and look in the mirror and just kind of talk to myself. How about that? I have no idea how many jacks you've just done. Let's start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 5 more. Okay. Wow. I think we're done. Thanks. Goodbye. See you later. All right. So here we go. Put your feet apart. And we'll just do a really strident quick warm-up here. Reach off to your right leg. And that right leg just wants to bend, doesn't it, when you do this? Try to keep that leg straight. And come on up. Let's go to the other side. Now let's go back to middle. Great. Just occurred to me while I'm in my heavy duty outfit here, I'm gonna turn the air conditioner on. And you know what? I think I should do that soon, but let's get warmed up first. I'm from Wisconsin. I don't like the heat. Let me go here. All right, great. Let's, there's a floor stretch I want to do specifically here. One leg out, one leg over. Now, cross your leg over top. In twist. Stretching not just the hip out, the lower back, the hip adductor, and feel across the glute, everything just feels really good. It helps the lower back. A lot of our kicks wind up contracting the back and bringing it into the spine, the muscles around the spine get tense and tight, and they never quite get a chance to loosen up. At least in my case, I'm guessing I'm like so many of us, but then we get a sore lower back and we think we have a bad back. Well, we just have a tight back, and to do the twist makes a big difference. All right, wide apart, and we'll just do this here, and then we're gonna move on. Okay, reach off to your side. Normally, I don't like to do warm-ups on our recorded classes. because I want to get right to it. But it's, I kind of tend to think it's a little bit of dead air, but I think it's important that we start off together. And if you want to do some more stretching, because I'm going to stop after this, just stop the recording and come back to it when you think you're ready. Let's go to the center. Okay. Now, take it from here. Bring yourself up. Let's just do some strengthening exercises for the legs. Wide apart. Let's say I'm here, there, I'm here with you. All right. So, toes just outside my heels, and I want to bring my weight down, bring my hands in. My hands give a counterbalance to my hips falling backwards. So I'm going to be here and come back up again. Just a standard squat. All right. If I had weight on my back, I wouldn't have my feet so wide. All right. So let's go here now. Now, take it in a little closer. Toes pointed together and dip down. Go as far as you feel comfortable. I'm going to go for 10. I think that's 10. I was starting to daydream. All right, so here we go. Stepping forward, somewhat of a lunge. Just letting that back heel come on up a little bit. So I'm going to go on the left and on the right. Moving forward. Doing it this way, you're going to get different angles with the camera. Okay? These come back and bite you. I haven't done these in a while, so we're going to stop right there. Okay, because I'm fragile, okay? And you may too be, may be too. There we go. Take your arm, roll it around. As we learn how to punch, we want to take care of our shoulder joint. You'd be surprised how much your collarbone comes to be important. You don't realize, you didn't think you have it or realize you need it until it starts to move on you. All right, so now take it back the other way. This way here. Yep, yep, yep. Okay, other arm forward. Ah, it feels good. Kind of feel like a heavy metal rocker doing this, don't you? All right, roll it back. Okay. All right, good. All right, let's go in the center. Just kind of doing a cross here. Kind of coming across. All right, let's get started. Like so here, I'm just going to twist and work to the side. Just like this. I should say that this is kind of like my workout. This is what I like to do. And I'm here at the dojo by myself, like now. And so I just try to keep moving for at least 30 seconds. All right, so here, put a good leg forward and just let your hands shift side to side. Okay, my left hand, my front hand goes out over my back shoulder. My back hand goes out over my front shoulder. My fingers are loose, you know, like I'm playing the piano. Just kind of going back. When I lead with my back leg, I go on, the weight goes onto my front. When I go to my front hand, my weight goes on my back leg, shifting side to side. If I wanted to, I go straight across this way. Neutral stance, go this way. But I don't want to. I only have one leg in front, one leg in back. Mm-hmm. All right, let's tighten it up a little bit. I'm just gonna work in front punch and back punch. Loose as can be. Okay. Now, from here in our program, the basic students, We want them to go through an eight block concept. Let's review that. Front hand. One, two, three, and four, five, and six, and then we go seven and eight, and we set ourselves back. And then we do a hit combination. Punch twice, elbow twice, knee strike, and front kick. Okay? So we're going to win. Put that all together. Let's do that three times. Ready? And go. From here, from distance position, we'll normally say back off, but I'm going to do this in a different way. So just be more fluid. Ready, set, go. Hands up. One, two, three, four, five, and six to the sides. Set it up. Hit twice, elbow twice, knee to the hand. Pop that front kick out. Come on back. Ready, and go. Seven, eight, set your hands up. One, two, three, four, five, and kapow. Good deal. Last time. Nine. Boom. Okay, cool. All right, come on back. So again, that was front hand, back hand, down, front hand down, back hand down. Now sometimes the kids think I'm doing this. We're blocking to our outside, out and out. Come right across the face, to the side, retreat back, jab cross, front elbow, back elbow, in, go. The elbows allow us to kind of start to develop what's called a hook punch and turn and twist off that front foot and back foot. That's why we put them in there. All right, so now, come on in here, set yourself up, and let's just do upper body here out of a shallow horse stance here. We're gonna be in this position here. What I wanna do is do all, we're gonna do our what's called Krav Maga elbow strikes here. So we're gonna go elbow with the front hand. I shouldn't say front hand, pick an elbow. Going forward, one, like so, to the side, two, behind you. All right, so I'm gonna go forward, side, back. Just to let you know what that looks like from the back here. Forward, side, back, okay? So I'm going the other side, forward, side, back. Forward, side, back. Forward, side, back. Okay? Down low. And then lean forward and up high. So I'm going down low, like somebody's got me in a bear hug, whammo, aiming for the solar plexus, aiming for the face. Okay? Down low, up high. Forward. With an upper elbow strike, and then an elbow drop. But you got to use your hips on that one. Forward, and then drop. Okay? So if I use my left arm, you can use your right. I'm going to go one, two, three. And down low, hands inside. Four, five, six, and seven. I use my right arm. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven, okay? Left arm doesn't go up very high because I've got a couple of pins in it, all right? So, but you want to get that left arm as high as you can, all right? Just like the right arm. All right, so here we go. Set it up on, let's go with your right arm first. So what are we doing? One, two, three, yeah. Four, down low, five, six, and seven. On the other side, one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven, okay? I think that's the best stuff out of Krav Maga, and that's why I kind of extract it and pull it out and use it. I think it's good stuff using those elbows. Now, going in here, let's go into a traditional karate set. Now we'll go into the horse, kind of more of a shallow horse stance, and now we'll do a traditional blocking. It'll go with our forms, which we'll do in just a bit. So here I go, one high block. I'm gonna do now like we did. I'm sorry to start and take a break here, but this is my left arm. All right, going mirror image of you. One, two, high outside, high in, middle out, middle in, down, down. Okay, so if I turn around, it's gonna go one, two, three, four, center, across the middle here. I'm exaggerating it, out, out, exaggerating, set, set, down, down. Okay, I'll do it going with, this is my left, this time from a corner, from the corner shot. Okay, third time, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. Coming down back, all right? Now let's go through our first, well, I would call it our, after we did the, what I would call the white belt set, again, what was it? It was the high blocks, the down blocks, center, the knees, and then more than Muay Thai style, hit through, elbow through, knee attack, and front kick. All right, that's going to be our white belt skill set. Now we're going to go up here a little more traditional, and we're going to go skip over because gold is included with orange and green. I'm going to do the green belt level form. Gold belts will work on stances, so we'll do the whole form, Heian Shodan. The stances we use in this form, do we use a horse stance in this thing? You think? No, we don't. We use a front stance. So gold belts are responsible for this stance, and we use a back stance. All right, and this is more for orange belts. Think about it that way. And again, I'm talking for younger students and stuff. Adults, teens, and everybody, you can handle all of them. So let me get a starting point. Now, the whole fun about doing Shotokan forms is they start and stop on the same point. So I'm going to pick back a bit. I don't really have a dot that works well, so I'm just going to guess. I'm going to say this one right here. Yeah, okay, cool. All right, and again, I'm going toward the mirror. This is my left. This is my right. All righty. I can go away from you, but I think you miss a little bit of it. And again, here we go. Try your best to hang with me. If I'm going so slow, go right by me. Yeah, Shota. Good. Down block to the left. Right punch. Down block to the right. Hammer strike. Down block forward. Three high blocks. Aya. All right, going in now, let's move up and let's do our three kicks. All right, we want to practice the white, gold, and orange. We want to practice here like so. We're going to be in. Well, let me back up. Let me back up completely. I was going to go in order of belts, but I'm going to bunch them all together like we have been doing. These are the six basic kicks, somewhat out of order. The order we go in is front kick, then side kick, then wheel kick, then round kick. I extract out the side kick and put that after the round kick. Okay. So what we want to, just because it flows better. So here are our six basics, all right, up through the purple stripe. So we go like this, just to do it. Hold on a flash, just for fun. I haven't left yet. There we go. My makeup's starting to run. So I, after 45 minutes of hair and makeup today, you know, I can't go back to the, get back to my trailer. I mean, I've got the moat, the show must go on, but I will call my agent. All right. So here we go. I need something to provide an obstacle. All right, this is a little low for me. Not really. So think about it this way. We're going to go in and the kicks we want to do on both legs. So we're going to go here. Let's just do the first four. We're going to go front kick over the pad, circle over the pad, round kick over the pad, knock the pad over. Let me do a redo on that one, okay? I think it wasn't me. I think it was a mouse running by here or something like that. That's a little disturbing. Let me try it again. Front kick, wheel kick, round kick. There we go. Side kick. That's what I like about the challenge of that. Makes you work. All right. So if we got front kick, wheel kick, round kick, and side kick. One, two, three, four. All right. I'm paying attention to that. That's why I like that. I'm going like, I want to make sure I don't knock it over. One. There we go. Two. All right. Three. Stay up there. Boom, can bring it back. Let's try it on the other leg. So we got front kick, wheel kick, round kick, and then side kick, just like so. Okay, let's do it again. Front, wheel, round, and side. Is that too fast? Let's try it slow. One, two, three, four. I know what you're saying, this is boring, you gotta kick faster, right? Well, kick your own speed. The last two kicks are what's called a hook kick. Hook kick's like a side kick, it's just that I bend my knee, and I hook it around, pull it around the back. I'm hitting with the bottom of my foot, and then from here I come up, I would do what's called an axe kick. All right, so I got my hook kick on this side, and then axe. Boom. As far as our adult program goes, those kicks are quite the front, the side, and the round are the big ones that really help us with our program. All right, they're the more practical kicks. Everything else after that is about developing just developing your core a little bit better. But they are fun to throw. Okay, now doing this way because I want to move forward and back. Okay, let's kind of take ourselves up a little bit. I don't know. Okay, fingers are crossed that I don't fall down. So we start off here. I'm gonna kick with my right leg. I'm gonna do all six, and then I'm gonna continue on with a couple of combinations that take me up a little bit higher. Okay, so we have front kick, we have wheel, and these are all with the same leg. Round kick, side, hook kick, can I bring it back? Axe kick, like so. Now from here, I'm gonna come up to this position here. Let's say things get broken up a little bit. So let's go like this here. We're gonna go side kick. I don't think I have a flow for that. So hold on a second. Let's go on to the left leg here. Yeah, I know. My apologies. Here you go. Here, one, and then two, and three, four, five. That's a hook, and six. Now, both sides are good. We try a side kick, and we do a turn and side kick, like so. We come on back. We do a round kick. We do a turn and hook kick. We come on back, okay? So those take us up a little bit past the first six. The turn side kick and the turn hook kick. We're just putting the round kick in there to make it a little bit more fun. So now I go to the third kick past that. It's a spin. I go from here, I spin and wheel kick. All right, so if you know how to do that, how do we practice that? Well, here, let's break it down a little bit, okay? Let's not just make today about working out. I wanna go here. I think it's better if I angle at you. Now you kick with my left and you kick with your right. All I'm really needing to do, everything starts with down here, my contact of the floor. So if I try doing this with me here, just turning your foot. I'm pointing straight out this way at 90 degrees to you. I'm going to turn it so that my left leg, my front leg, is pointing toward the back of the room. Now, that allows me to wind this up here. I see how my foot will kind of turn with me a little bit. So as I do that, my leg out in front that's getting pulled comes across, okay? And that's how I do it. If I want to do this, I go all the way around, which I'll teach the children how to wind up their legs crossed, and you do this. If you recall, we do a wheel kick by learning how to cross our legs up and then pull it up and come back. And all this does is just add a turn that it takes a while to get. And then the completion of that little kick doesn't have to be high. You just got to do it, you know, 1,000 times or so, and I think you'll be close. So you go around with a spin wheel kick, okay? End up with a front round kick. End up with a punch. Boy, you got something there, okay? So if we're here, one of our higher belt combinations for the red belt is to do just that. I spin kick, I wheel kick, I spin wheel kick, then a round kick, and I punch. We'll do that one on the editing floor. One, two, three, okay? Other side, one, two, three, all right? So as we get going with that, be here, I crank my front foot, bring my back leg around, get it to the mat. As soon as I can, I pick up my front leg, and then I punch. I want that all to flow together. Now, what I'm looking at doing this is I'm looking at my feet, making sure they stay on the same line. I don't want them crossing and doing all this. I want them to be here. I'll try. If I fall down, help me back up. Spin. So far, so good. Round. So far, so good. Punch. I think I got it. All right. And then, not bad for 102. All right. I want you to try it as well, if you're up for it. If you don't, go like this. Wheel kick. Round kick. Punch works well. Axe kick. Round kick. Punch. That works well. The spin just adds a little bit of fun to it. Be careful of your knees, your ankles, your hips. Be careful. Okay? So, those are our kicks. That's what we're going to do. We can do those freestyle in our house without any equipment at all. All right? We worked on elbows, blocks. We did a couple of forms. I did one form, actually. All right, so let's move on up and do a couple of the intermediate forms now. We're going to be in position here. I bow. Ready? Oh, book, 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 book. Heaven forbid. Where are my manners? I want to be back here. Let's do Hion. Yidan, number two. I like this form. It's a good form. Okay. Now I'm going to do it. Maybe, sometimes I can't help myself. I'll do a little explanation. But for the most part, if you don't know this form, watch it, you know, and then we'll catch up with it. But if you want to work along with me, I'll talk through it a little bit. Obviously, we have an attention stance and bow. Ready stance. Hion, Nidan. To the left, everybody. Hands to the hip. Side kick behind. Open hand, knife hand blocks. Left, right, left. Spear hand. Turn. One, two, three, four. Knife hand. Block out. Kick and punch. Block out. Kick, punch, step through. Augmented block. Down block. High block. Down block. High block. Come on back. All right, so going through Hion Sandan now. This one's a little bit more, got the hands moving a little bit more. We like this one. All right, so bow, set. And camera, I am cool. All right, hands on our hips, leg up,
strikeout.
Leg up, strikeout.
Leg up, strikeout. Up, through.
One, aya, two, and come on back. Just a little bit of a, I believe in martial arts to be practical. I'm kind of a practical, I'd like to say a practical person, but I would like to say my martial arts, I'd like it to be practical. Nothing wrong with dance. Nothing wrong with it at all. But I want my, I took karate because I want to learn how to defend myself. And I'm thinking like, Hian Sandan, I'm not getting it. I don't understand. What are we doing? And so when I'm here like so, I'm coming up in this position, my right leg comes up and down. Now, in some styles of Japanese karate, and there are many of them, that can be. It's either, some use it as a crescent kick. Some use it as, well, a knee strike. Some use it as a stomp. And the answer is yes, all those are true. All right? It was explained to me that this crescent kick was going to knock up like a weapon out of somebody's hand or to block a punch. I just can't see that happening. He might be able to do that, but I doubt it completely. What I do see this though, is if I'm here, a lot of times I block, you can block techniques to the lower body, like with your shin, with your knee, with your leg. When we block off to the side, we're blocking a kick to our leg. And I see that kick here, pop, coming through, maybe having some sort of effect and blocking it. I don't think I'd ever use it for that. Okay, because I think it leaves your groin completely open for a strike. You're not quick enough. But maybe you can do it with your front side. You can just get your leg across here. But coming from the back side, I'd say that's rather difficult. What makes a better explanation is if I'm here, I've got my attacker in a headlock. I've got his arm drawn across me. I step and I throw him over my hip. I like that idea. I like the block. I also like the idea of coming in like a low zone kick here, like so, and driving down on the foot or the shin or something like that. That makes sense. So I'm just trying to put a practical aspect on what we're doing. Otherwise, you know, why even do it? Because there's no reason for it. So my whole thing personally against traditional karate was just that. All right, I got my breath back. Let's go here now. We've done the intermediate forms. We've done some of the intermediate, a little bit of the advanced kicking. Let's just leave the kicks alone for a bit, because after that we have to use a bag and everything. So I tell you what, well, that's a good idea. Why don't we pull a bag out and let's do a little bit more of an elevated segment on how to hit the bag or how to hit the hand pad. I'm thinking this one. Yeah, that one works. Work for you? Okay, good. All right, so I get this set up, and let's give you the numbers. Okay, all right, I'm gonna stand at the side here. All right, so we're gonna like so here. Just to give it full effect, well, let's go barehanded. I don't have time to go digging in the back. I was gonna put my gloves on, but that's not that necessary. All right, so here we go. We want to think about hitting the bag. Now, let me do it this way, please. I think it'd be better if I came at it from this side. Yeah, the director said this is my better side. Okay, I got the sun. All right, good. Action, rolling, camera. All right, so what's great about the Wavemaster, commercial interruption, it's got this with scoring targets, gives you something to aim for. All right, so you probably can guess what that is. Sternum, chest, head, you know, and a regular sized person. I'm just a shade under 6 foot. So these pads are, you know, about that high. And so for the most part, for most of us, this kind of covers a good swath of it. And so this is a knee and below, alrighty. So I have the knee is open. Thanks right here. I don't want to hit this hard part. All right, so now that's kind of like if you're new to class and everything, pardon me while I tighten this belt. So I'm going to be set here. Now I'm looking at here, this pad, which is the 4, which is the 5. And that's straight out from my heart. Now a lot of people, when they hit the bag, they'll hit straight out in front here, like they're doing like a weight press or something like that. It takes a lot of work to do this, and that's to hit high. All right. So we want to punch up high. We're going up here like so. All right. Now what I have is my front hand. In this case, it's my left. Is going to jab. All right. On Monday, we talked about the fast punch. We want to do it a little bit anyway. We want to have that coming off the chin and driving right in here. So if I work at my distance, so I can't kick the bag, where I have to move in to kick it, I can come in here and strike. So let's just think about the hands. Jab and cross. Going in. You have a bag? No bag. I'm just going to be this way. Just be careful of how well you're punching. Let me grab something here to show you something. Now, these are 10-pound hand weights I use for my broken down shoulders and everything. I want to go, if I go like so, I got to be careful. That's going to be hard on my joints. But if you have something, this represents it, I can have something here. What we call heavy hands. We used to have, I don't know, boxing coach used to use railroad spikes when he was down by the railroad yard and stuff, how to punch something heavy in your hands. If you want to put a bottle of water, you know, anything with a little bit of weight to it. If you're not hitting the bag and you're just kind of working here, don't let your elbows go to lockout. All right, coming down back, jab, cross, one, two, hit high, hit low. Like so. Now let's hit high and high. I can't tell you how satisfying that is. Unless you're doing it with me. All right, let's add some other punches here. Now I'm gonna hit high on purpose. All right. Sometimes you'll see in some of our forms, you see a grab and a hit like this here. Right? I grab and boom, I'm coming across. If you want to interpret it that way, if you understand a little bit of boxing, how to come over the top to jab, you know, or how to follow a punch back, that's fine. But this just allows me to develop a high punch. I want to get my hand up. I want to get my shoulder up, and I'm throwing kind of an overhand punch, not too much of one. The counterbalance that is going to be what's called a body hook. And that's if I'm here, coming here this way. This is a really strong punch, all righty? Just a, personally, I'm left-handed, so I like to throw this punch really when I would spar and stuff in contact, you know? And so I wouldn't want to get hit with it, but I would like to throw it from time to time, all right? And you can watch out how hard you hit somebody with this, because if you catch somebody open, you can really do some damage. The least of which is knock the wind out of them. The most of it, you can break the ribs and, you know, cause, you know, all kinds of problems for them. Set back to training quite a bunch. So if I'm like this, I go jab, punch. As I hit here, I drop my weight, and I'll come underneath here now, where I would think the elbow would be. So here's my elbow. So what am I looking at? Between the 5 and the 8, or the right around where the 7 is? Let's see if the 7 matches up to that. 1, 2, perfectly. Oh, yeah. So that's the one we want to aim for. 1, 2, pop, like so. When I throw a body hook, hit, and I don't stretch out. I hit, and I cover back up again. That's important. Okay, so 1, 2. Let's do a set of 10. It's 10. I don't know, it feels like 10, but I tell you what, it's fun to throw. Really fun. Now, if you get a little bit better at this, 1 and 2, slip, you're slipping outside the right hand coming at you. I'm going to hit the body, I'm going to come back, boom, like so. I'm going to come up and hit up upstairs, or I mean up top. All right. So, what's upstairs mean? Somebody asked me that one time. Well, up here. Okay, so we gotta go jab, cross, body, head. And since I'm there, I might as well throw another one of those too. It's only fair. So going through that like here, we're gonna go in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just like so. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Throwing two punches with one arm, I'm gonna load up. It's kind of nice to go back and forth. So it takes practice to go 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. Alrighty, that's how we like to do it. Now we wanna add a little bit of flash to that too. We can add some covers and blocks and everything. Now defense lab is where we were doing the covers, the head and the elbows and stuff. Defense lab is really good at street protection, or protection without any rules and stuff. You're gonna cover your head up and everything. Well, I think like a lot of self-defense systems, they miss the mark because they take a few simple concepts and then try to make a 5-year program out of it. You know, yeah, I suppose you could. Krav Maga does the same thing. You need to have more than just hitting the bag or hitting pads and stuff. Or stunt fighting and everything. You need to have the ability to train with somebody unrehearsed, as long as you follow the rules and watch your control. Okay, the head's got to be open, but you have to wear a head mat, a head pad, and then have a mouthpiece in. And it's better to have face protection too on that, so that you're protected. And even with that, hits to the head can really damage the neck if you're not careful. So it's all about, well, our posture is really important. Having said that, I can go 1, 2, 3, and I can come in here with an elbow strike. This is my defense and attack, a term I really love that defense lab has. I got my elbow here. My other elbow is up high, keeping the backhand protected. Boom, I'm going in. And maybe I'm just going center mass. Why would I do that? Why wouldn't I try to hit him in the face or something like that? Well, first off, that would cause tremendous damage. That may be your goal. But the other part is it's hard to hit the head. It's easy just to push somebody away. You're trying to get clear. You're not trying to score points. It's not a movie. If I'm in here like so, I'm going to get down because something's going to come at me. You know that. You hope that it doesn't. So that's kind of like my rationale behind it. That's why. And another thing is I'm going from super far out, medium, inside. Okay, then I want to get back out again. All right? So, hit it like so. We can go in, hit. And I spring in my elbow strike from here. I come back, I strike through. If I slip and fall, I have my body, I've fallen against it here. And if you think back on the form we just did with the hands on the hips, we have elbow strikes we do at the end and stuff. So I work from here. So now I've gone to this position. I've gone in 1, 2, 3. Right? So, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then let's just stay consistent. I'm going to go in here. You can grab the arm too. I prefer just to do it freestyle. This. Boom. Let's say if I slip and fall, and all of a sudden I got my back, my attacker's got me around the arm. I have maybe my elbows are tight and pinned. I have strikes low. I have the head. That makes a big sweaty mark on my back. Then if I can release, I've got high end here. I can bring myself back, you know, and I can play fight some more. All right, so that gives me a chance to do a great bag workout. A little bit of drama in there as well. Sweaty head. All right, so working the bag. Jab, cross, body shot. Body hook. Left, right, hook. Left, right. Underneath. 1, 2, elbow. 1, 2, 3, 4. On and on and on. I can change it and make it my own, so to speak. If you have one of these bags, if you're hitting with an elbow, be careful of the snapback, because if it hits you in the head just right, it can hurt your neck. Just speaking from experience. Okay. All right, so set it in. Drive it in like so. Hand technique. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now again, we're adding elbow here, we can add elbow here, we can step across the front of the bag, and then I can work it out from the backside, working the rear deltoid. All right, or stance and everything. Going low, left to the quads and the groin, pow, pow. Trying to hit anything I can to get free. Ready? Okay, super deal. Take your leg and do a stretch here like so. All right, stretch your leg so. Okay, let's pull the bag out of the way. Let's go to the next thing. All right, so now we're gonna finish up with our basic forms. And that's a patronizing sound. They're not basic, they're very complex. But they are our first five, six forms. They are the ones that get us going here. All right, they take years for us to practice them. I believe we want to master them. They look simple, they're not. Nothing is. Nothing worth attaining is that simple. If it is, we don't respect it. So where are we at? We're at number four, heon four. It seems like a good enough place to start. We'll go in and we'll bow. We'll go ready stance. I'm not even sure where our clock is. I just know we're moving right along. Heon yodan. Go ahead. And then we bring it back. Okay. Heon godan, number five. Like so. Taiki Shodan. Let me start here. Since we don't go forward and back in this form, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to do it with you. I'm going to go this way. Let me show you the steps here from this way. I bow, I go here. Right leg together, left hand over. We'll work at the legs on this side, all right? Cross, strike to the right. Use a knife, open it up. Hit the elbow with your right hand. Pull down to your right side. Strike below your left, body hook. All right, hope you can see that. I step across my weight, knee strike, lock out with my elbow. Punch and block, I go over the top. My left hand is out over top of my right fist. My elbow is right here. I'm going to sweep or kick and turn to the left. Sweep, kick, turn to the right. Pull my hands in to the right. Aya, step to the set. Let me get my stance proper. Slide out. Do it all the other way. Step, cross. Now, when I do this, I want to think about getting across my attacker's leg. You know, and I can come up inside it. So really, inside, here, over the top, sweep, and then aya. Okay. Looking at you forward, going here, set, just relaxing. Boom. All right. We'll call that our first six. Now, if you're one of our upper belts watching this, I want to come up with a black belt form that we all can do. I was thinking about MP. Yeah, that's a good form. Let me show you, everybody, adults and everybody, whatever, regardless of belt color, whoever's watching this, Kankudai. Conquer Day. And that's the form we started with when we made our transition to traditional forms. I think that that'd be a great school form, a great black belt team, or master team, whatever we want to call ourselves. Not quite masters, but it's fun to think that way. We'll go like this here. And we'll set this up. I think going this way, going straight at the mirror, probably give you the best representation. All right, here we go. Okay. My hands go apart. I'm gonna reach up, hands up, like I'm looking through my the hole of my hand, so to speak, at the sun coming up. Look at the setting sky or the rising sun. I pull out, right hand into left. Chop, chop. The wipe is not part of it. Crossover. So I'm here. This hand goes into my center, goes right into my center. This hand comes over the top of it. Another time where I'm crossing, I'm blocking, and then switching over to the other side. One, two. Okay, now this is my blocking or control hand. I'm gonna hit, pull back here, and strike. Ready? Some people think that's a block. I like to think I'm throwing a strike. Right. Hit, strike. Regardless of what it really is, I like to do it that way. Pull into the side, side kick, 3-9. And spear, Aya. All right, there's our first Aya right there. All right, weight on her front leg, driving it out here. All right, what makes Conquer Day unique is this next combination. I have block and chop, I front kick, I turn, back to the mirror, and then back stands. Mind you. And repeat. All right, near and dear after my heart, we had side kicks in this form. Grab elbow, and then four knife hands. And then chop back again. Kick, and this time we follow through. Back this, block, hit it, come up, and drive down. Come up, knife, turn, catch, block, punch. Double catch on here. Double shot. Step up. Hammer. Double strike. Hold it tight. Down. Flip. Catch the kick. Catch the punch. Boom. Break. Break out of the bear hug. And go here. Side. That's solid. All right. That's our black belt form. That's what I want you to do. Okay? Let me grab a bow. All right. Using a traditional set with the bow. I'm not a traditional bow. Enthusiast or anything. I do like it. I do like these better than just, tournament twirling and everything like that. I understand that that has a lot of appeal for younger students, but, for us old duffers, we're going to have a little bit of a gravitas to it. And I think we think of gravitas as relating to gravity or depth or weight, if you like Latin. All right, so we go like this here. Mine is a real light bow, so I'm kind of cheating in that regard. So, well, we'll go here. This is Shushinokan. All right, bow. And now for our karate students, we're going to come here. Now I move to my left, and I reach across my brow like this, and I grab here, and I step forward. Or, I'm sorry, I step back and punch forward. Horse stance, shift to the left, pull this foot back a bit. Lock, strike the foot. This is the only time we don't step, okay, with this block. Here, hit, through, and then hook block. I'm in a cat stance here, and what this tells me is this leg has to be free, all right? So make sure your heel is off the ground and most of your weight, if not all of it, is on this back leg. All right, my elbow's high, I shift, strike foot. Now I step through, but I have a little bit of a difference here. I go here, I switch my grip, striking left, and then switch back. I go right, back, drive, thrust forward, and hook block. Moving to the left, strike, trying to stay in camera. Doing this five-part combination. Again, and again, and again. I'm breaking the rule by looking in the mirror, not looking where I'm going, but I want to see and make sure that I stay in the center, all right? So now we get to this point. I want to go cross my feet back, step back with my left leg. At the same time, I kind of do a little curl here. So I'm going to be here. I'm going to come back like this, and I turn. I take this as we strike to the corner, okay? That's how we play it. There's our yep. Right here. Come back, and then we go here again. We're going to come back, drive here again, hook block, and I'm going to go wide, block high, drop, sweep, bring it up to our right side. Right hand back, left hand in front. Left, right, hook that leg up, drive it forward. Four-point combination, and aya. Hook block, we got that. Okay? Now, that gives us a great weapons form. It is solid. It is in with the traditions of how a bow is supposed to be used. And hopefully we follow that tradition to the best of our ability. Let me put my bow down to the side here. All right. And let's work on finishing up. Ready? So some of the things we worked on today, we worked on the bag. It's kind of like I'm an enthusiast for punches and kicks, so I like to do that a lot. I know our students like the bows and the forms. We don't include here right now today is sparring. All right, although I do struggle with myself when it comes to decisions and everything like that, it's kind of hard to spar yourself. All righty, so we'll save that for another day when the COVID panic scare is kind of like gone downhill a bit. Finishing up here. I just want to say, I hope this recording has some utility. You can come back to it for some things that you'd like to see. So put your feet apart and reach off. Whenever you get done working out, let's do a little bit of a stretch. Okay? Hopefully you can go farther than you did before. Okay, coming up and over. Keep in mind, just to let your body relax, you're going to find some resistance in the beginning, and as your leg feels a little bit more safe, it'll just start to loosen, your hamstring will start to loosen, and you can fall forward. Not only that, your lower back. You're going, okay, bring yourself up. That's good. I like to think of that as a metaphor for a lot of things. You push at something, you don't know you have skills, you think you're at the limit, you're at your limits, and then you're challenged a little bit more, and you go to a different level, a higher level that you never thought you could hit. When I put on the wall here, can you see it? It says, discover how great you can be. Sometimes that gets misinterpreted by, I don't know if you can see that there or not. It says, discover how great you can be. And what it's meant to me, what that means is, so you have talents that you didn't know you had. Martial arts is an education, and it's not the only education for physical body, but you can take yourself through athletics, and you can, through proper coaching, and through proper training and your own self-discipline, you can take yourself to levels you never thought you could reach. Team sports, that's extremely difficult because everybody's got to be working on the same page, but the lessons learned are life lessons. Working for yourself, an individual like you do in martial arts, also difficult because there's just you. There's nobody else to rely on. But if you challenge yourself, you can take yourself to new levels that you've never thought you could reach. Now, you can take that example and apply it to every aspect of your life. If you're at work, I can't tell you how many times you're stuck with a problem and you may have to take a walk or you have to think about it, and all of a sudden you can find a way out of it, find a way to work forward. So keep that, just from one broken down black belt from Green Bay, Wisconsin to the rest of you, just take that and keep that in mind. I'm sure all of you know that rule, but keep learning it, keep practicing. So we go forward here now, and this workout this week, I think we went pretty far. We had a good time. I know I have to use a second uniform tonight. That's all I can tell you. All right. It's going to hit close to 90 today. So yay. Just love summer, don't you? All right. So have all the best. And you take care of yourself.